After studying this chapter, you shall be able to understand the nature and meaning of current and capital account transactions, the meaning of an authorized person and how such authorized person concern one in day-to-day affairs, rules regarding current account transactions and the restrictions thereon, why the withdrawal of exchange for travel to or transaction with Nepal, Bhutan is prohibited, the status of a current account transaction which is not prohibited and does not appear in Schedule 2nd and Schedule 3rd, powers of RBI to issue regulations relating to capital account transactions, investments by a person resident outside India and permissible capital account transactions. Now we will discuss upon current account transactions. What is current account transaction? Current account transaction means a transaction other than a capital account transaction that includes, first, payments due in connection with foreign trade, other current business, services and short-term banking and credit facilities in the ordinary course of business. Second, payments due as interest on loans and as net income from investments. Third, remittances for living expenses of parents, spouse and children residing abroad. And fourth, expenses in connection with foreign travel, education and medical care of parents, spouse and children. Second, who is an authorized person and how does an authorized person concern one in day-to-day affairs? Authorized person means an authorized dealer, a money changer, offshore banking unit or any other person for the time being authorized in writing by RBI to deal in foreign exchange. One has to deal only with the authorized person and no one else when one, first, deals in or transfers any foreign exchange or foreign security. Second, makes any payment to or to the credit of any person outside India. In other words, remitting money out of India. Third, receives any money or payment by order in any manner from abroad. Third, what are the rules regarding current account transactions? In terms of the FEMA provisions, any person may sell or draw foreign exchange to or from an authorized person if such sale or drawal is a current account transaction, which means there are hardly any restrictions. Fourth, can it be inferred that there are no restrictions on the drawal of exchange on the current account? It can't be said that there are no restrictions on drawal of foreign exchange on current account. For this purpose, the transactions can be divided into three types. First, those prohibited by the FEMA transactions listed in Schedule 1st. Second, transactions which require the prior permission of the government transactions listed in Schedule 2nd. Third, transactions which require prior approval of RBI transactions listed in Schedule 3rd. First, Schedule 1st, prohibited transactions. There are certain transactions for which the drawal of foreign exchange is prohibited. These are as under: A. Travel to Nepal and Bhutan. B. Transactions with a person resident in Nepal and Bhutan, unless specifically exempted by RBI by general or specific order. C. Remittance out of lottery winnings. D. Remittance of income from racing, riding, etc. or any other hobby. E. Remittance for purchase of lottery tickets, banned proscribed magazines, football pools, sweepstakes, etc. F. Payment of commission on exports made towards equity investments in joint ventures, wholly owned subsidiaries abroad of Indian companies. G. Remittance of dividend by any company to which the requirement of dividend balancing is applicable. H. Payment of commission on exports under rupee state credit route. I. payment related to call back services of telephones. J. Remittance of interest income on funds held in non-resident special rupee account scheme. 6. Why are drawal of exchange for travel to and transactions with Nepal, Bhutan prohibited? This is because of exchange control purposes. Rupee accounts maintained in India A. By citizens of Nepal, India and Bhutan. B. By residents in Nepal and Bhutan. C. By Indian, Nepalese and Bhutanese firms, companies or other organizations. D. By banks functioning in these countries are regarded as resident accounts and rupee transfers to such accounts for imports into India or for any other purpose may be made freely without reference to RBI. Hence, sale of foreign exchange for current account transactions with persons resident in Nepal or Bhutan or against imports into these countries made by residents in India is prohibited. 7. The status of a current account transaction which is not prohibited and does not appear in Schedule 2 and Schedule 3. Remittances for current account transactions which are not specifically prohibited under the rules or which are not included in Schedule 2 or Schedule 3 may be permitted by the authorized dealers without any monetary percentage or ceiling subject to the compliance of Section 10, Subsection 5 of the Act. Remittances for the transactions included in Schedule 3 may be permitted by the authorized dealers up to the ceilings prescribed therein. 8. What is the compliance of Section 10, Subsection 5 of the Act? Section 10, Subsection 5 of the Act provides an authorized person shall before undertaking any transaction in foreign exchange on behalf of any person require that person to make such a declaration and to give such information as will reasonably satisfy him that the transaction will not involve and is not designed for the purpose of any contravention or of invasion of the provisions of the Act or any rules, regulations, direction or order issued thereunder. This simply means that the onus of adhering to the FEMA Act 1999 provisions is shifted from the authorized dealer to the person who undertakes the foreign exchange transaction. A very simple example is the utilization of international credit cards issued by banks in India and by Indian tourists abroad. The onus of adhering with the FEMA rules and regulation is with the tourist and not with the banks, whereas earlier banks used to release foreign exchange depending upon the eligibility under the extant regulations. Now, the next topic of discussion is capital account transaction. What is the meaning of a capital account transaction? A capital account transaction means a transaction which alters the assets or liabilities including contingent liabilities outside India of persons residing in India or assets or liabilities in India of person outside India and includes A. Transfer or issue of any foreign security by a person resident in India. B. Transfer or issue of any security by a person resident outside India. C. Transfer or issue of any security or foreign security by any branch office or agency in India of a person resident outside India. D. Any borrowings or lending in foreign exchange in whatever form or by whatever name called. E. Any borrowings or lending in rupees in whatever form or by whatever name called between a person resident in India and a person resident outside India. F. Deposits between persons resident in India and persons resident outside India. G. Export, import or holding of currency notes. H. Transfer of immovable property outside India other than a lease not exceeding 5 years by a person resident in India. I. Acquisition or transfer of immovable property in India other than a lease not exceeding 5 years by a person resident outside India. J. Giving of guarantee or surety in respect of any debt, obligation or other liability incurred. A. By a person resident in India and owed to a person resident outside India, or B. By a person resident outside India. 2. Powers to issue regulations relating to capital account transaction. Section 6 of the FEMA Act empowers RBI to specify, in consultation with the central government, the classes of permissible capital account transaction and limits up to which foreign exchange is admissible for such transactions. Section 6, subsection 3 of the FEMA Act empowers RBI to prohibit, restrict or regulate various transactions mentioned as under by making any regulations. A. The manner and form in which declaration is to be furnished by an exporter. B. The period of limitation and the manner of repatriation of foreign exchange by person resident in India. C. The limit up to which a person can possess any foreign currency or foreign coins. D. The class of persons and the limit up to which a foreign currency account may be held or operated. E. The limit up to which the foreign exchange acquired by way of gift or inheritance or any income arising therefrom may be exempted. F. The limit up to which foreign exchange acquired from employment, business, trade, vocations, services, honorarium, gifts, inheritance, or any other legitimate means may be retained. G. Any other matter which is required to be or may be specified. Third, investments prohibited by a person resident outside India. A person resident outside India is prohibited from making investments in any company or partnership firm or proprietary concern which is engaged in the business of, first, chit fund, or second, a nidhi company, or third, in agriculture or plantation activities, fourth, real estate business other than development of township, construction of residential, commercial premises, roads, bridges or construction of farmhouses, or trading in transferable development rights, TDRs. Fourth, permissible capital account transactions. Capital account transaction of a person can be classified under the following heads. First, transactions specified in Schedule 1st of a person resident in India. Second, transactions specified in Schedule 2nd of a person resident outside India. All the capital account transactions would thus be subject to rules, regulations, orders and directions made thereunder. Schedule 1st. Schedule 1st to regulations under FEMA permissible capital account transactions specifies the following. A. Investment by a person resident in India in foreign securities. B. Foreign currency loans raised in India and abroad by a person resident in India. C. Transfer of immovable property outside India by a person resident in India. D. Guarantees issued by a person resident in India in favor of a person resident outside India. E. Export, import and holding of currency, currency notes. F. Loans and overdrafts, borrowings by a person resident in India from a person resident outside India. G. Maintenance of foreign currency accounts in India and outside India by a person resident in India. H. Taking out of insurance policy by a person resident in India from an insurance company outside India. I. Loans and overdrafts by a person resident in India to a person resident outside India. J. Remittance outside India of capital assets of a person resident in India. K. Sale and purchase of foreign exchange derivatives in India and abroad and commodity derivatives abroad by a person resident in India. The RBI has laid down regulations on each of the above matters. Schedule 2. Schedule 2 specifies classes of capital account transactions of persons resident outside India, which are as under. A. Investment in India by a person resident outside India, that is to say, first, issue of securities by a body corporate or an entity in India and investment therein by a person resident outside India. Second, investment by a person resident outside India by way of capital in a firm or a proprietorship concern or an association of persons in India. B. Acquisition and transfer of immovable property in India by a person resident outside India. C. Guarantee by a person resident outside India in favor of or on behalf of a person resident in India. D. Import and export of currency notes into from India by a person resident outside India. E. Deposits between a person resident in India and a person resident outside India. F. Foreign currency accounts in India of a person resident outside India. G. Remittance outside India of capital assets in India of a person resident outside India. Now let us summarize. Current account transaction means a transaction other than a capital account transaction and includes payments due in connection with foreign trade, other current businesses, service and short-term banking and credit facilities in the ordinary course of business, payments due as interest on loans and as net income from investments, remittances for living expenses of parents, spouse and children residing abroad, and expenses in connection with foreign travel, education and medical care of parents, spouse and children. A capital account transaction means a transaction which alters the assets or liabilities, including contingent liabilities outside India of persons resident in India, or assets or liabilities in India of persons outside India and includes transfer or issue of any foreign security by a person resident in India, transfer or issue of any security by a person resident outside India, transfer or issue of any security of foreign security by any branch office or agency in India of a person resident outside India. A capital account transaction means a transaction which alters the assets or liabilities, including contingent liabilities outside India of persons resident in India, or assets or liabilities in India of persons outside India, and includes transfer or issue of any foreign security by a person resident in India, transfer or issue of any security by a person resident outside India. Authorized person means an authorized dealer, a money changer, offshore banking unit, or any other person for the time being authorized in writing by RBI to deal in foreign exchange. One has to deal only with the authorized person and no one else when one first deals in or transfers any foreign exchange or foreign security. Second, makes any payment to or to the credit of any person outside India, in other words, remitting money out of India. Third, receives any money or payment by order in any manner from abroad. A capital account transaction means a transaction which alters the assets or liabilities, including contingent liabilities outside India of persons resident in India, or assets or liabilities in India of persons outside India, and includes transfer or issue of any foreign security by a person resident in India, transfer or issue of any security by a person resident outside India, transfer or issue of any security or foreign security by any branch office or agency in India of a person resident outside India.